This is the F-22 Raptor, the most lethal and dominant air-to-air fighter jet in the world. With the ability to fly at speeds upwards of 1,500 miles per hour while carving through the sky with its stealth technology and thrust vectoring capabilities, the F-22 has certainly earned the title King of the Sky. Well, today I'm out here with the Hawaii Air National Guard at Hickam Air Force Base to bring you up close to the F-22 and learn what makes this the most feared fighter jet in the world.
Hi, Captain Pete Watt Vanley Ribbink, F-22 pilot with the Hawaii National Guard out here at Hickam Air Force Base, Hawaii. Behind me is the fifth generation stealth fighter, the F-22 Raptor, world's most capable and deadly aircraft. Some attributes that make it so lethal are stealth capability, our supercruise, our sensor fusion, and our ability to have high situational awareness in the current battle space.
So let's break that down. When it comes to stealth capability, the F-22 is coated with radar-absorbing paint called LO, which stands for low observability. This is what allows the F-22 to remain virtually undetected on enemy radar, and by the time it might finally show up, well, it's usually too late. The F-22 is an air dominance fighter, meaning it was designed to outperform and outmaneuver anything in the sky. It's capable of flying twice the speed of sound, up to 60,000 feet high, and is extremely maneuverable. The Raptor comes with two Pratt & Whitney F-119 turbofan engines that each produce 35,000 pounds of thrust. These engines allow the F-22 to maintain supercruise, a term used to describe the ability to fly supersonic without using afterburner. The pilot also has the ability to control the direction of the thrust up and down by roughly 20 degrees in what's called thrust vectoring. This is what allows the F-22 to perform some absolutely ridiculous maneuvers that almost seem to defy the laws of physics themselves. When it comes to munitions, the F-22 can carry 6 AIM-120 radar missiles as well as 2 Sidewinder heat-seeking missiles. It also comes with a 6-barrel Gatling gun which can fire 6,000 rounds per minute. It's an absolutely fascinating aircraft, and here at the Hawaii Air National Guard, the units are comprised of both active duty and traditional guardsmen, a concept called total force integration, which was designed to create an even more effective and efficient Air Force.
The Hawaiian Raptors are a total force integration unit, and the Air National Guard is the lead. We have an active associate here, which means that there's 2 fighter squadrons here, with the Air National Guard making up 1 fighter squadron and the active duty making up the other fighter squadron.
Sam, well, welcome back to the jet. I know it's been a minute. Must be good to see the Raptor in person again.
I definitely miss her. She's looking good. It's been a minute. But yeah, this angle right here was always my favorite, right? Because it's such a massive aircraft. But when you look at it straight on, it just seems to disappear because of that stealth and those angles, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, not only was the jet designed to defeat radar via stealth, but actually its signature, when it's pointing at something, really reduces its visual pickup. So great observation. When we're pointing at something, it's really difficult to pick us up visually.
Yeah, well, I know I've seen it before, but I definitely want to give the viewers a chance to get up close and take a look at this thing. So let's do a walk around and go to the first stop.
Perfect, sounds good. So this is the office space, I guess you could call it, for the F-22. So as you can see, it's a single seat fighter, no two-seaters ever built. So for your first flight in the Raptor, it's no kidding a solo with, you know, a national asset. So a huge responsibility, but it's a tremendous airplane to fly. One of my favorite things about the F-22 is the situational awareness that we get from all the sensors and data sharing that we have. And that's kind of all happens in the cockpit where we have all our displays, all that data information is processed to make it very user friendly. So we have tremendous amount of situational awareness in the battle space.
Must be one of the best offices in the world, right?
And it's not a bad view.
I am just so bummed it's only a single seater because this is the one aircraft I would love to experience what it's like to pull 9Gs in. So I'll just have to take your word for it.
Absolutely. You know, 9G, it's a monster. It's got 70,000 pounds of thrust with 2 Pratt Whitney F-119-11 engines. So it is absolutely a beast to fly. A lot of fun, a lot of power. Goes where you want it to go, does what you want it to do. Hey Sam, for our tools, we got everything stored internally to help reduce our radar cross section. So we've got 2 AIM-9s, those are IR, kind of within visual range, short range missiles. In the main weapon bay, we've got 6 AIM-120s. Those are, I think, in medium range type missiles, radar missiles, where you're shooting beyond visual range. And then right up here, we've got the gun. It's a 20 mic mic, six barrel Vulcan cannon over there. We do have the ability to do air to ground stuff in which we can carry 2x JDAMs or 8x small diameter bombs. But really the bread and butter of the F-22 is gonna be our missiles and our bullets.
Now, when it comes to the F-22's weapon systems, the technology from Raytheon is what supplies the Raptor with the munitions it needs. In fact, it was the F-22 that was recently called upon to blast a Chinese surveillance balloon and several other high-altitude objects right out of the sky, using Raytheon's AIM-9X air-to-air missile. But to be on the leading edge of defense technology, you have to continue innovating, and that's exactly what Raytheon has done. They're working on a trio of effectors across multiple platforms, including the F-35, F-15, and F-18, with the AIM-120 AMRAAM leading the way. With the form, fit, function refresh, and software upgrades, the AIM-120 D3 and C8 are like a whole new AMRAAM, with longer range and more capabilities than ever before. When it comes to air-to-ground, Raytheon has the Stormbreaker Smart Weapon, a network-enabled weapon with a tri-mode seeker that can fly more than 45 miles to strike mobile targets even in the worst weather conditions. This reduces the amount of time aircrews are having to spend in harm's way. And completing Raytheon's air dominance portfolio is the Joint Strike Missile, a long-distance, highly survivable and maneuverable weapon that takes on heavily defended targets on land and at sea. With the JSM, Top Gun Maverick would have been a much shorter movie, as a Joint Strike Missile could have navigated the entire mission, firing from far away. It's no secret that Raytheon works on some incredible technology, and if this is something that interests you, they're hiring across their entire company. I've left a link in the description below where you can go to learn more about career opportunities and how to apply. And a huge thanks to Raytheon for making epic videos like this possible.
Welcome to the rear of the F-22. We've got two Pratt & Whitney F-119 engines capable of producing 35,000 pounds of thrust apiece, so that's 70,000 pounds of thrust. Super capable engines, very reliable. We're a Mach 2 type airplane that can get us up to about 60,000 feet. Another great asset for the F-22 is we're a super maneuverable airplane. We've got massive flight controls as well as thrust vectoring. What you can see on this engine right here is the nozzles are actually in the open position. Once the jet starts up, those things will actually compress to go zero. And then when we're flying, we can actually manipulate the nozzles to either deflect upwards or downwards. And what that helps us do is just makes us very maneuverable when we're doing BFM, basic fighter maneuvers, so thinking within visual range, dogfighting type stuff. So it gives us a great, great platform to be highly maneuverable and then highly lethal.
All right, Watt, one of my favorite parts of the F-22 is just how massive these flight control surfaces are. Can you talk a little bit about what these things are able to allow the F-22 to do?
Sure, absolutely, Sam. So like you said, flight controls are massive. The horizontal stabs are actually about the size of an F-16 wing.
Yeah.
They're center point pivot, so we get insane maneuverability off of the horizontal stabs. Another really cool thing about the F-22 is it's fly-by-wire. So for other pilots out there on the traditional Cessna, Pipers, when you do left pedal, that's gonna command left rudder. But on this airplane, it'll actually send up the core processor and the airplane will actually determine what flight controls to manipulate to best solve that pilot's request input. So it absolutely optimizes maneuverability and just makes it a very easy, smooth airplane to fly.
It really is like flying a futuristic spaceship, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. It's an amazing airplane. Just looking at it, it looks like it's not from this world.
So now that you've had the chance to look at the F-22 up close, I say we head inside the squadron to see where the pilots gear up and mission plan before every flight. But it's also more than just the pilot in the jet. Inside this squadron are hundreds of airmen from all different types of career fields who come together to help accomplish the mission.
So right inside here is aircrew flight equipment. Now you can basically think of that like a locker room, but for F-22 pilots. It's where they all go to gear up before each flight. Now there's actually a training mission taking off a little bit later this afternoon, so a few of the pilots are in there gearing up right now. I say we head inside and check out some of that gear that they wear for every flight.
So we just briefed, just stepped, got all suited up to go fly. This is the gear we're gonna go fly with, starting from feet to cranium. This is our G suit. This hose connects us to the jet. Once we're under G, this will actually inflate their little bladders in here, which help from blood pooling in our lower extremities, which helps keep us conscious. The F-22 is a 9G airplane, so definitely need every advantage to optimize the envelope of the F-22. Working up, this is our harness. So we've got a lot of goodies in here. Got some snacks, some radios, In the case we do have to get out of the airplane, we do have some resources to survive on the ground and also coordinate for rescue efforts. Up here, this is our LPU life preserver unit. Once we hit water, this will automatically inflate to keep us floating above the surface. And then here we've got our, effectively, this is connects us to our parachute risers in the event that we do have to get out of the airplane. This is what connects us to the risers for our parachute. Moving over to the helmet, we'll put this on. This is where all comm happens, as well as our oxygen. So again, this connects to the airplane. We get oxygen supply. And then here, the mask. This is where our communication equipment is, where we can talk between each other, as well as in our earpieces to receive. So quite a bit of getup, a lot to wear, but keeps us safe. And our AFE guys do a great job making sure that we're always ready to fly.
And of course, if you're an F-22 pilot, you've got to have a rage button. So here we go. As the pilots strapped into the jet and the maintainers prepped the aircraft for launch, I was able to get a front row seat for the entire thing. Now, because the F-22 only has one seat, that means I'm not going to be able to go up for a ride. However, the Hawaii Air National Guard wasn't going to leave me hanging, and in fact, they treated me to the next best thing. Seeing the F-22 through this video really only gives you a part of the story. But if there was one thing I wish I could convey to you, it's the feeling of being able to watch it blast off in person, standing out on the runway just a few feet away. It is absolutely wild.
Well guys, there you have it, the mighty F-22 Raptor. This aircraft will forever be one of my favorites, and it was a blast getting to hang out here with the Hawaii Air National Guard to showcase this incredible platform. Huge thanks to the entire team here at Hickam Air Force Base for having me out. And as always, I hope you guys learned something new. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll catch you next time.